Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Mirror Neuron, which means watch and learn. And today I'm going to share with you another interview question, and this is related to the Python NumPy array. And this question is pretty simple, but it's quite fun when you are trying to do it in your Python labs or in your Python environment and getting the solution. So the problem statement is very simple. So say we have an array which looks like this. So basically this is a 28 by 28 pixel image of a Hebrew alphabet called Shin. Okay, so this is the the grayscale image of that picture of the Hebrew alphabet Shin, and you can see there are many values which is one. So basically they are white color, and you will see there are many small values, 0.76. If you minutely see it, I'll zoom in, of course, 0.76, 0.7, those are like darker pixels. So basically eventually you get to see the alphabet, right? Okay, so the problem statement now is, so you can see that there are many white pixel which are of value 1. So if I zoom in into this little bit, so you can see right here on the left side, you see a value called 1.00, then 0.76, then 0.48, which is line number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th, the 5th line from top. Okay, so what I am interested in is if I can get an array which will capture whenever there is a change in the pixel value. Okay, and if that pixel value is not 0 and 0. So for example, if I zoom in further, so if you see here, just next to 0.49, there are two consecutive zeros, right? So I need the index position of those zeros, and also anywhere where there is a change in the pixel value. Say from it jumps from 1 to 0.76, and then from 0.76 to 0.48, I need the index position of each of these value. So basically, I need a tuple of all this index position put in a Python 2D array. So if I zoom out, so basically your output would look something like this, 5,4 where that value of 0.76 was, and then the 5,5 was the value where 0.48 was, and so on. And then it goes along the horizontal axis, and then it goes vertically down as well. So this is the output that I am looking for. So have fun in trying to solve this kind of problem, and this will basically help you in clarifying the basic properties of such libraries like NumPy and other. All right, so I hope you'd be able to solve this, and if you do so, just share the approach that you have taken. Also make sure you calculate the time, because if it takes too much of time, then again it will not be a viable solution. So typically in an interview, they not only look for how you're solving it, but also how much time it is going to run that on your computer is also very important. All right, so I hope this is another question which will help you inquisitive mind. So just try this out and let me know.